Let's shift gears now and talk about ways to avoid programming in the first place. There are many libraries available for CUDA. More come out every day. There are some libraries that are developed by NVIDIA, some by third parties. There's open source libraries and there's commercial products. And of course, there's no way I can cover all the available libraries out there. But I do want to hit a few highlights here and talk about some of the more popular and useful libraries out there. The libraries I'm going to talk about are, for the most part, fairly mature. They're designed and optimized for performance by experts, and they get tuned up and re-released every time a new GPU architecture comes out. So if you can use these libraries, you should. So the first thing I want to highlight is called QBLAS. Now, QBLAS is an implementation of the Blas, or Basic Linear Algebra Subroutines. This is a venerable library that's been around for a long time. It's used in Fortran and C, and scientists and engineers everywhere, you know, use this as one of their go-to workhorses for dealing with dense linear algebra. Next is CUFFT. FFT stands for Fast Fourier Transform, and so not surprisingly, this is the CUDA Fast Fourier Transform. This includes various batched transforms, as well as support for various, real-to-complex, complex-to-complex FFTs, and so forth. It has an interface similar in ways to the FFTW, the popular fastest Fourier transform in the West routine. So it's a familiar interface to anybody who uses FFTs as part of their bread and butter toolbox. CUSparse is Blas-like routines for doing linear algebra on sparse matrix formats. Sparse matrices, as you know, are matrices that are mostly zero and therefore stored in some sort of compressed format. And CUSparse supports a variety of formats, including higher level routines like incomplete LU factorization. CURAND is a bunch of pseudo and quasi-random number generation routines for making random numbers. And this includes device-side functions as well as host interfaces for quickly filling arrays with numbers drawn from particular distributions, various high-quality random number generations, basically. NPP stands for NVIDIA Performance Primitives, and this is basically, for the most part, low-level image processing primitives, so highly optimized low-level primitives for image processing. Magma is developed by the same group that wrote the original LAPACK library, and LAPACK is another one of these tools in the toolbox of many scientists and engineers who simply use these tools for linear algebra all the time. So Magma provides GPU and multi-core CPU implementations of many LAPACK routines, so it's sort of a modern parallel rethinking of or implementation of LAPACK-style linear algebra. Another linear algebra tool is CULA, which is implementations of eigensolvers and matrix factorizations and matrix solvers, and for dense matrices, similar to the LAPACK API, and there's also a sparse CULA package as well. And ArrayFire is a framework for data parallel manipulation of different types of array data, including a wide variety of built-in operations from numerical linear algebra to signal processing to financial. So this is somewhere in between a domain-specific library like these others and a programming power tool, which is sort of the next category we'll talk about.